just released Idols. She's just released her single called Best Friend. So I'm sure you've watched the video on YouTube. She's coming out with her EP, right? It's called Mr. Big Shot on June 23rd. So let's all welcome Wallice. Can you say hi to
Hey.
Okay, anyone's question? First question? Go ahead, Kevin.
Hi. Afternoon, I'm Kevin from Manila Concert Scene. Welcome to the Philippines. How was your trip so far?
It's been great. I've been a little bit sleepy, so I didn't get to do as much exploring as I'd like so far, but I really love it here.
Alright. How does it feel to be signed with Dirty Hit?
It really is like a dream label. I honestly didn't know too much about them before I had meetings with them. Like, I didn't realize like who was on their label. But after meeting with them, they're amazing and they have a great roster, like 1975, Viva Indy, Rina Sawayama, and I'm very honored to be on their roster.
Alright, congrats and enjoy the show later. Good luck.
Alright, can you please tell us more about Best Friends, how it came about, the message behind the song, or if there's any story that's related to the song that you could share with us?
Best Friend is a song, like friendships throughout my life that I was drawing from when I was writing that, but specifically like my best friend from when I was like 10 years old. We don't really talk anymore, and I think a lot of people can relate to that, to losing a friendship or a relationship in your life that you keep thinking about and you want to reach out to the person, but it's just not something you could do anymore. And so I think a lot of people can relate to losing a best friend.
Right. The last EP that you released was 90s American Superstar.
Yes.
So which 90s American Superstars fascinate you the most and why?
I love Gwen Stefani and her like No Doubt era.
Yes.
Early 2000s.
Check.
I love her.
Alright, thank you.
Hi, my name is Laura from Parma. I would like to talk about the show that you're about to perform in a few hours later. So how does it feel right now that you're about to perform later in the Philippines?
I can't believe that I get to play my music and share my music all the way here. I think it's not necessarily not that many artists get to come here to play, especially someone I'm very small in comparison. So I'm so, once again, honored to be opening for the 1975. And this, I think, will be my biggest show ever. So I'm very excited.
I hope you enjoy
me.
Thank you.
Hi, my name is Jimmy from Soundcheck Manila. So I heard that you've been touring with the 1975 for a while. So how has it like been touring with the band and you get to interact, learn anything from them, and vice versa?
Something that I really respect about them is their entire crew is extremely nice and like welcoming. That's not always the case on tour.
Yeah.
And they also, I really love how they change up their set a lot. It's not the same set for 20 shows straight, which most people do. They change a song here or there, or like make something a little bit special each show, which has inspired me moving forward in my set lists.
So you change yours a bit also every now and
then? I change it once so far. It's a little bit harder because I have such a short set. We have like opposite schedules. When I'm working, they have free time. When they're on stage, I have my free time. So I didn't get to see them too much, but every time I have interacted with them, they're super sweet and a dream.
Thank you.
Hi, Edison from South Lake Business Air. You mentioned Gwen Stefani earlier, and I've read in your biography that you're also inspired by Lana Del Rey. And your category is into pop, which I believe is from the same category as the likes of Billie Eilish. Have you ever been compared to these artists?
I don't think I have been compared to Billie. I've met her a couple times, but she's very sweet, and I love her music too, so it would be great to be compared to her.
Yes. And aside from the 1975, have you ever opened for other popular acts?
This is by far the biggest tour that I've been on. I haven't toured too much. My career started during the pandemic, so my brain was only started to sense. last year I went on tour with an artist called Still Lucy. That was my first tour. And then the last month I was working in the US for an artist on the kid called Johnny. And then so Lucy. And I also opened for Wallice, which
oh,
they
have. They just performed here.
Yeah, I saw that
a few
too,
months back.
I think in February. I opened two shows for them too, but this is, you know, the longest run, the biggest shows.
My last question. Before you traveled to Manila, have you ever encountered Filipino fans or collaborated with Filipino musicians?
My boyfriend was my guitar player. He's half Filipino, so he'll be on stage tonight. I got to see some of his family yesterday. That his mom's from Kansas City, so very close. And my touring photographer is half Filipino too. I'm half Japanese, so love Asian
yes.
in general. I've only ever gotten a couple comments like I come to the Philippines. But hopefully I'll make a lot of new fans tonight and tomorrow.
Hi, I'm Rafa from Malibu. You mentioned earlier that this is like your biggest tour ever. So how do you deal with like the nerves for like the stage show before it's not a big fan to
me? Yeah, the biggest show before this tour was 5,000. And then the first show on this tour was like 10, so that was like visually double the size. And like walking into the empty room with all the lights on, I was like so nervous. And usually, since I have been touring for a little bit now, I don't necessarily get nervous before shows. But that first show in the beginning of last month, I was like back to like starting out like so nervous. But I think after trying two shows, then it just becomes like, it sounds silly to say, but like another day at the office, kind of. And like I walked out to the room here, and it is the biggest so far, but it doesn't feel too scary. I'm excited. I'm just more excited than nervous.
And what do you think is the best part when you get to go to the concert?
It's really fun being able to see their show every night, but I think the main reason that anyone would take the tour besides loving them is just the great opportunity to reach so many new fans that you probably wouldn't be able to just through the internet. I think so. I can every night win over a couple people at least to become fans of mine.
I just noticed from your previous EP, it's like after you're now Mr. Big Shot, it's like came from like a pretty simple title to something a bit sassy. So what inspired Mr. Big Shot and experience?
My first two EPs are a little bit character based, like 90s American Superstar. Like I'm clearly not that, but I'm very inspired by like film and television and movies, as that EP like can suggest. And this next EP is a little bit more like personal and like personal stories. And I still love to incorporate like humor within my lyrics and visuals and like even song titles. So this was some with more like serious songs that are very personal. I was able to kind of bring in that element of humor that I like with Mr. Big Shot.
off camera, are you a funny person? Would you say you're a funny person off camera?
I hope so. I think so. Am I?
Of course.
Am I?